Good morning, everybody. It's really good to be here talking to you about the ArcGIS platform today. I wanted to give you guys an overview that'll help you get the context for the rest of the plenary. So ArcGIS is advancing. It's both contributing and integrating many new innovations in areas like analytics, smart mapping, 3D, and many others. This last year has been an incredible year in terms of advances across all of the different areas of the platform, including ArcGIS Enterprise, Pro, regular releases of online, the production release of Runtime version 100, the JavaScript APIs, the 4X releases, the 3X releases, releases of all our applications. So all of these things have happened since we last met, and you'll see a lot of that this morning. So if we drill into the ArcGIS platform, this is its essence. Its users are working with information, using applications that connect to the platform. The platform provides identity, an information model that's made up of maps and scenes, layers, analytics, and also dashboards, story maps, as well as other information products. All of this is powered by services, and those services expose and work with data. This makes this platform truly distributed. You can implement it on premises or in your chosen cloud. That's the platform available to deploy in your own infrastructure. We call that ArcGIS Enterprise. It's also available for you to use online as an organization within ArcGIS Online, which is our SaaS system in the cloud. This slide drills into that information model tier. It shows how applications and developer applications built using our APIs connect to the platform and work with these information model elements, these high-level elements, the maps, the scenes, the layers. They really abstract the information. They serve multiple purposes within the ArcGIS platform. They allow end users to author them using applications that are familiar to them and expose them as, you know, these very tangible things, maps and layers. But actually, behind the scenes, those are powered by things like feature services, image services, geocoding services, spatial analysis services, geoanalytics services. So all of the system is services-based, allowing it to be very distributed. At the same time, these high-level abstractions really make it easy for people to configure the system, as well as for applications to realize functionality very quickly by actually working with these entities, right? These are items in our portal information model, and they're very real with respect to our developer APIs. And you'll see that this morning. So now let's talk about the different aspects of the system, the components of the system, if you will. ArcGIS Enterprise is a very large part of our work and our release this last year. It is ArcGIS for Server. We've renamed it to ArcGIS Enterprise because that really captures the full dimensions of what it is. It's a complete GIS in your own infrastructure, and it includes all of the familiar components that you expect. It's got the portal, it's got GIS servers, data stores. And these additional capabilities are deployable as specialized servers. So this is something new at 10.5, the notion that in addition to the GIS server that works with your portal, you can have these specialized servers, the image server, the geo-event server, the geo-analytics server, the business analyst server. They've become more decoupled, they've become more focused on their purposes. And all of them, working with the portal and with the back-end data stores, help you realize your functionality. And they can run close together, or they can be spread apart as needed. At 10.5, of course, you know, we have enhanced geospatial capabilities, and we'll talk about them. We also have aspects like portal collaboration via item replication that allow you to connect different instances of ArcGIS Enterprise together. The distributed architecture that I just spoke about, automation enhancements. So this is a really big release for ArcGIS Enterprise. This is showing this ability to connect these different instances of ArcGIS Enterprise together. So you might have Enterprise deployed in different departments within a large organization, and also a central enterprise-wide system that's used across the organization. Well, these can all be connected and share information through item replication. We'll be doing the same thing with respect to an on-premise deployment of Enterprise and ArcGIS Online running in the cloud, and you'll see that happening this year. ArcGIS Online is ArcGIS available as SaaS. It's very popular. You're making amazing use of it. There's great growth in the numbers of users, in the numbers of items they're creating, in the number of map views, and we've been working hard at it with regular quarterly releases. And each of those releases has new capabilities, things like the ability to create views on feature layers, the ability to generate your vector tiles in Pro, upload them to online and serve them out, the ability to create and have hosted 3D layers, so lots of functionality through the year, and more to come in all these areas that you see, including continued improvements to the core experiences. You've seen them come out through the year, and you'll see more coming out this year in areas like search, continued work in content management, and of course, mapping, 3D, all of the core areas. These are some of the enhancements that you've seen come out through the past year. You know, continued focus on smart mapping, on web app builder, the introduction of drone to map, the ability to take its outputs and upload them to online, configurable 3D apps and hosted 3D data, vector-based maps and online. Moving on to content, the Living Atlas is a key aspect of ArcGIS, right? It's compiled from the best available sources. It has the base maps and the imagery, the demographics, you know, the substrate of data that's really needed to power your applications, but lots more, thousands more, and all of these are powered by data sets. It's available online, and we've spent a lot of effort also integrating it, the access to it, through ArcGIS Enterprise and through ArcGIS Pro, so that if you deploy those systems, it's available to you. They connect directly to online and make that seamless. ArcGIS Pro and ArcGIS Desktop are an essential part of our platform. They are both consumers of information from the platform, and they also create information that can be disseminated and used in this platform. We've seen huge releases of Pro through 2016, and that's going to continue into 2017 with lots of functionality for things like vector tile creation, 3D object editing, image classification, ortho mapping. So a lot to share with you, and you'll see that through this week. So if I were to summarize this part, it's basically to say that ArcGIS supports multiple implementation patterns. You could have standalone desktops working with information, servers that all they do is serve out geospatial services, or you could have complete deployments of the full platform based on ArcGIS Online or ArcGIS Enterprise. And increasingly, these systems themselves are being connected to each other, leading to a system of systems, an interconnected network, and we see that emerging too. So ArcGIS is truly distributed. Apps make the platform real for our users. We build them, you build them. And we think of apps for the field, apps that can be used in the office, apps for the community and for engagement with constituencies. And these apps, they're very active. There's been a lot of development, and there have been continuous releases through the year. For example, in the area of apps for the field, things like support for high-accuracy GPS receivers, the release of Survey 123, the web version, Workforce on Android, and you'll hear more about those. We've been working on the next generation of these apps based on the latest releases of our runtime APIs, and the team is here this morning, and they will share that with you. As builders and developers of apps, ArcGIS has lots of technology for you. We build our own apps using these technologies, and these are available to you as developers. In terms of building apps through configuration, we have the web app builder, and we have App Studio. We have configurable apps. These are incredibly popular, and they've been used to build a huge number of applications, and we see great growth in that. Then we have the runtime and our JavaScript API and all of the SDKs around those. And they really let you get at all of the functionality in the platform. We've been working hard on these, and we continue. So you've seen releases last year, you'll see releases through this year, and you're using them. And we'll talk a lot about them this morning. So now I want to move on to the capabilities of the platform. Data management and data integration, it all begins there. And ArcGIS gives you a lot there, like you already know. In terms of the core information, feature services have been innovating rapidly through the year. Things like views on layers, levels of details on features, change tracking, archiving, sync. But we're also working on more advanced information models, for example, for utilities, a new services-based information model, together with the ability to do long transactions via versioning, all through a services model. And you'll see that coming out this year, by the end of the year. Of course, continued support for different databases and data access technologies. We're working on geocoding. You've seen that release through the year. So a very active area. Mapping is key, right? Mapping and visualization. It's for both presentation as well as understanding. Smart mapping is a real focus for us because it helps people understand their data at, you know, through exploration and before they start drilling into it with deep analytics. Time is an area of focus. We've also been working on vector tiles, both in 2D and 3D, as well as mobile map packages. You'll see and hear about them. 3D is a very important area. We've been looking at all of the different information types, including point clouds, integrated meshes, 3D objects. For each of these, we're building layers that make it easy for you to work with them in applications. We're also putting a lot of work in sharing the core specifications of these with you so that you can access them through our APIs or directly, however you choose to. That includes the packaged versions of these, work on scene layer packages. So you'll hear about that this morning. Analytics is a very important area, right? ArcGIS has rich desktop-based spatial analysis, spatial statistics, geostatistics, geoprocessing, all of it in desktop and pro, and also available through Python. We've also been working on new interactive user experiences for analyses that we've released in Insights for ArcGIS, and you'll see that. Big data is an area of focus. We've been working on parallelized analytics on both vector and raster data so that things that take days can be done in hours or minutes. And we're building user experiences for these so that people can drive these server-based analytics through Pro, through the web map viewer, through our APIs, and through Python notebooks. And we'll present that to you this morning. Imagery is a hugely important area, both for visualization and information dissemination, on-the-fly analysis, as well as analysis at source resolution on really large data sets where the results can be persisted and reused multiple times, raster analytics on big data. All of that is powered by the ArcGIS image server, which has these image services for dissemination as well as for persisted analytics. And you'll see that. Real-time is another really important area, right? It's used for asset monitoring, vehicle tracking. The Internet of Things is all about, you know, sensors, measurements that flow into this for real-time analytics, as well as archiving and subsequent batch analytics. We have connectivity to the Azure IoT Hub, to the Amazon IoT Gateway, and real-time is a key part of the platform, especially when coupled with geoanalytics. So if I were to sum that up, you know, we would say that ArcGIS enables multiple types of systems, This has always been the power of GIS, right? GIS does data management, data wrangling, data integration, it does mapping, it does visualization, it does analytics. And ArcGIS brings all of these aspects together, and you're using it to implement systems of engagement, systems of insight, and systems of record, or connecting to systems of record for insight. And in doing all of these, you're enabling the science of where. So in conclusion, you know, our platform has been and is advancing, and we're working on all of these areas, and we're looking forward to 2017. To this plenary, we'll share a lot of it with you, and we continue our work. So thank you.